Hey, I'll call a meeting of the Conway Board of Selectmen to order on Monday, February 16th at 6 p.m. First thing on the agenda is our minutes for the January 30th, 2017 meeting. I'll make a motion. We approve the minutes.
You second? I had no issues with it.
You second? Looks good to you?
Yeah.
All of your favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay, that's pretty easy. Okay, next minute is warrants, the vendor warrant. Do we have dollar amounts, Tom? I don't have a sheet.
Yes, sorry.
Oh, to be added, you're right. Would they be right on here? Thank you.
First is a vendor warrant for $43,369. And the second is a payroll warrant for $102,745 and a payroll deduction warrant of $26,805. I'll make a motion that we approve the vendor warrants and the payroll warrants.
Second.
Any discussion?
There they are.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Those all three carry. Minutes attended by the selectmen. You must have went somewhere.
I did.
I know you
So Friday, John and I went to a meeting of the Connecticut Valley Superintendents Roundtable. And we were invited there by the Frontier Superintendent. Yeah. And it was, you know, I'd never met her before, so it was interesting to meet her and all of the other superintendents from what I would more think of as the Pioneer Valley, yeah. But they call it the Connecticut Valley, but it's the same idea. And we had a presentation by a fellow from the Massachusetts Taxpayer Foundation. Mm-hmm. And it was a very bleak look at the state's financial health. and how little money we're taking in to some extent, and how expensive mostly it is for Massachusetts to pay for health care. Mm-hmm. And with no solutions. I mean, everybody wanted to ask, what can we do about this? And he was unwilling to say raise taxes, but I don't know. He had no other solution. So, but it was a good meeting. Okay. So the only other thing for me to mention, which isn't a meeting I went to, but it's a meeting tomorrow morning, is that I have a meeting with Comcast to go over the Comcast maps of the extension they're doing here in Conway. So for people that are
site plan,
people that are watching at home might want to hear that. So
looks like we got some pretty darn good coverage coming up, huh?
We do. Yeah, I would say nearly every home in Conway.
That's great.
When you posted that map, and we had a lot of interest. Because the map is really very crude. And so if you look at this map of the roads in Conway and a colored line marking the ones that are going to get extended, some of them, whoever did the felt tip marker to mark them in wasn't exactly accurate.
Mm-hmm.
And
okay. And
for everybody who wants to get broadband, this is really important. So,
sure.
What was really great was some of the people that wrote to me worried. I could tell them the extension is going to go from this road to this telephone pole number.
Mm-hmm.
And some people actually then immediately drove down to the pole just to verify the pole number. And some people sent me back a photograph of the pole.
Wow.
And because they want to know, you know, how is this going to go.
So, great.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that's tomorrow morning, but I don't expect I'll learn anything new. I'll hope to learn a couple new things, but we'll see.
Great. Okay, did it?
Yeah.
Okay. Next item on the agenda is citizens' concerns. Do you know of any, Tom?
We have some citizens.
Any citizens' concerns?
We're here to listen.
Okay, all right.
Thank you.
If none, we'll pass on to the next one, which is old business. Housing Committee signed agreement with the owner of Sheehan property for the PERT testing. Tom, you must have information about that.
The Sheehans added a new set of contingencies before they would agree to the PERT tests. And the PERT test has now been canceled. They will be having another meeting tomorrow.
The Housing Committee.
Yes. And they'll be making final decisions at that point. But they have asked because of the decision on the part of the Sheehans that they this item be tabled for now.
Okay. Sounds good. We'll table this item then.
So I don't know if that answers your question.
I guess our question is really, does that mean that the deposit that you have made on the property is still in effect?
I would say come to the Housing Committee tomorrow, 7 o'clock, I believe, and that's one of the things they're going to talk about.
Very good. Thank you.
Great.
And thanks.
And
is that the only?
Given that the PERT test has been canceled, there's a good chance that will happen. But that's a decision to be made by the Housing Committee, not by us.
Of course, I wondered if you had news.
Or they're going to talk about it.
That's what their choice is, they would come to us and recommend that we have it canceled. Okay. And we had to sign it.
But they haven't met yet.
They haven't met to formally decide that. Yeah.
Understand. Well, thank you.
They will come back next Monday, I presume, with a report for us on it. So.
Yeah.
Great.
Hey.
Okay, off we go. Thank you.
Fiscal year 2018 budget update. Tom, you must have a lot of information on that one.
Yes, and I'd like to do it actually in conjunction with the warrant update as well. All the numbers in now, except for the schools.
Okay. And, they're minor, right?
And they're always the last to come in always have some surprises for us. We actually do have a number for the Franklin County Technical School.
Okay.
We don't have one yet for the Smith, Volk, and Tech School.
Is that the number that's on the sheet, Tom, or is it?
That's the Frontier number.
No, the Franklin County Tech number here.
Under Technical School.
Yeah, is that the accurate number that's on here?
That's the accurate number for Frontier. And that is $12,000 less than last year. So that's
for Frontier or
that's
school?
Good. That's for
what do you got, something different item?
Franklin County Technical School.
Well, you got something
is
different
is item. The number that we have.
I got mine's under Tech School. Nothing.
I have item 320D Technical Schools. Yeah, that's what I have. Same thing right here. Mine's red. Mine's printed red.
But that's wrong. He said that's Frontier.
Oh, I'm sorry. That is Franklin County or Franklin Regional Technical.
That is technical.
Just like technical.
Yeah. Frontier
is above it, and I should have those numbers on Wednesday.
Okay,
great.
The grammar school I might also have on Wednesday. Actually, their final meeting is going to be the 17th. But I won't have the final numbers until after the 17th. But I'll have enough to get my preliminary budget out, and the preliminary estimate is that the budget will be going up roughly 5%.
For grammar or both?
For the grammar school. As you know, the healthcare is a big part of that, and that's going up about 10 and 11% for the basic plan and the preferred provider plan for everyone, town staff, everybody who's in the Hampton County Group Insurance Trust. So
is this budget mostly caused from less students going there, probably?
That's probably why. We'll get the official word in a few weeks.
Oh, okay.
So this is everything I have now is preliminary.
Okay.
And we've gotten a request from the Wastewater Committee to consider a proposal for engineering for that. It went out to bid, and instead of being part of the normal capital process with them submitting it and all that, they were in the process of doing that, and they didn't get any bids, but they did get some interest from Ty and Bond, who would have been one of the bidders. And they are working together now to come up with a proposal that would refine the scope of services.
Are they going to come in and propose this to us, or?
I am hoping that they propose it to the Capital Improvement Planning Committee.
That makes sense, yeah.
Which is going to be meeting on February 22nd. And that that you get a recommendation from them. Because now that we do have a capital planning process, I think it's good to use it.
Yes, it is.
Of course, the chair of the Wastewater Committee is interested in moving the item forward and isn't necessarily looking forward to spending another year on it. My own feeling is that if he did have to spend more time on it, it would be a good opportunity to talk more with townspeople about its benefits and see whether or not he could find, build substantial support in town for it. I don't think it's a crushing blow if it weren't able to be done, but as you know, it's been going on for some time, and unfortunately the lack of bids did not help things along this year. So that's a major item that wasn't on last time.
These are all still subject to being voted on, correct, Ollie?
Oh yeah, there are no select board recommendations or finance committee recommendations on here. The warrant closes mid-March, early to mid-March, and at that point the select board and finance committee can sit down and everything that is going to come forward has come forward, so you're dealing with a finite set of circumstances. Things are still a little bit fluid now. So that's the timeline for that. I don't yet have a number. I've been asked by town staff here in the town office to request improvements for the town office, and there are a number of improvements.
That's
now under Article 11. I don't have a figure for it yet, but it'll be somewhere under $10,000. I imagine it'll be a substantial, but not huge amount of money. It's floor work, bathroom work.
It's needed.
Yeah. It's been needed for a while. I'm not sure whether we covered this last time, but the Capital Improvement Planning Committee decided on $3,000 for a hard pack in the back, what's down there now, if it's oil and stone or whatever it is coming apart, and we need some kind of even surface back there rather than letting what's there just fall apart and break up. Mm-hmm. The assessors do need a new computer system. I think we went over that last time. There's some repurposing. I don't know. We won't know until we look more closely at the ambulance numbers exactly how much is needed to go to the ambulance stabilization fund and how much for operating expenses. Okay. Though, because their budget is $717 over what they asked for last time, I'm going on the assumption that the operating expenses will be $717 higher than they were last time. That leaves only the amount going to the stabilization fund to be decided. A note on Article 17, the assessors, there was a change in the Municipal Modernization Act that said that all of the overlay reserves could be in one account. Before, they were in different accounts by the year in which they were
created.
What
are overlay reserves?
Those are things that are set aside for abatements and exemptions by the assessors at the beginning of the year. We'll be setting aside about $35,000 this year in order to pay off abatements and exemptions that people apply for over the course of the year. If it's not all used up, it stays in a fund. Previously, it was limited. You had to pull it out year by year. Now, it's all going into one lump sum.
And it stays there.
Which is available to the assessors to pay for example, the revaluation. Now, and I say that because the revaluation has now gone up to every 5 years instead of every 3 years. Though adjustments are made year by year as they go along, they're more or less estimates, with the big revaluation being once every 5 years now. So instead of, normally there was a larger number set aside for what they call the triennial revaluation. Now, we're since it's going year by year for 5 years, we've lowered the amount to $5,000 and we're calling it the recertification of property values. So the revaluation is once every 5 years, but it does have to be, go through a process annually. So that's what we're, that's why that language has changed. It had always been revaluation, now it's recertification.
So we'll put money aside every year?
Yeah.
And then that will be used every 5 years to do the, I'll call it the revaluation, but the recertification of values.
We can ask Lee about the exact process. There is some work that happens annually.
Okay.
So, but the, yes. The revaluation is certified, which is, I guess, the technical way of putting it. The land is all revalued, and then that revaluation is certified.
I see.
So that's...
so if it's every 5 years, we'll save we'll have $25,000 saved up over the 5 years?
I believe so. You'll have to check with Lee for the exactness on that. Again, some work is done annually, so I'm not exactly sure how that gets spent. We have the number now for local library operation. We have a number. The governor's budget came out the end of January, so I've been plugging some of those numbers into our revenues and expenses. And that's good. I think, you know, I went over the town clerk bill from a previous fiscal year. We're now being billed for something we previously weren't.
Yeah.
We won't have community preservation fund figures until we get further along in developing the budget, because they're all based on budgetary figures.
Right.
More repurposing. Oh, and, you know, I have this $100,000 thing in here twice. I meant to take that out before this, but Article 22 doesn't need to be there because it's actually Article 5 now. Again, I try to arrange the articles. So first people vote on the operating budget of the town, then they vote on the capital items in descending order of expense. So we get the things that are most expensive debated first, and theoretically more important, but you know, some of the smaller ones are important too. And that's how I've proposed arranging the warrant now.
This repurposing in Article 23, Tom.
Yeah.
That's $7,788 there.
Yeah.
Is that, when you say repurposing, what's going to... Oh, I'll show you. Excuse me, I read it wrong. So you rebuild the tennis court and basketball. Okay.
Yeah, and it won't be enough if we end up having to pay for it ourselves, and town council is looking into the contract with Weston and Sampson.
Will that be enough to do that?
It won't be enough, but it will certainly be a start. You know, it'd probably be half, I would say. I shouldn't even estimate.
Seen it shoddy work from the beginning. I would hope that town council could pressure the contractor to fix it the right way.
Well,
we would hope.
Yes. And Lee will be asking for a senior tax work-off program. Many towns have these, and the select board has to decide, okay, we'll allow $5,000 or $10,000 of tax money that people owe the town to be worked off if they're seniors. So this is a senior tax work-off program. Once you get to be a senior, which can be defined by the board as well, then people, you could say that if it were $5,000, that 10 people could work $500 worth off of their taxes if the town had work under this program for them to do. So it's a way to...
What kind of work would we want our seniors to do?
Clerical.
No, that would be good.
Different things.
Not join Rania, you know.
Not spend wood.
That's what I'm wondering. Yeah.
Lee has a lot of scanning to do. I'm sure Johnny has a lot of scanning to do too. For
that would be great.
Preservation of public records, that sort of thing. So that's what that's all about. There will be two or three articles from the planning board. First, the right to farm bylaw is being finalized. The Ag Commission had a public meeting, and a bunch of people showed up.
Oh, good.
And including people with concerns, and they went through the whole proposed bylaw and got pretty much, I think, resolution on all the issues of the people present anyway.
They're going to present that to this board before town meeting?
I certainly hope so.
Yeah.
And I'll call them up, make sure they... I was thinking that I was going to get the text before this evening, but I didn't. Maybe it's this week I'm going to get it. And then two or three planning board bylaws, certainly two. One of them, they have revisions to the setback requirements that they're going to propose, and they'll be having a public hearing on that soon. And they will also be having a hearing on adding a table of contents. Because it's a change to the zoning bylaws, they have to have a public hearing for it and all that, just to add a table of contents, but they figure that will help people find things and be easier to use. They had been planning to have an amendment, and they may still have an amendment. It may be general instead of particular, but it would involve the situation of if we wanted senior housing somewhere in town, we would have to change the zoning, because right now we're limited to duplexes as the maximum occupancy for lot. So
the planning board is working on that?
Yes. Yeah. So I think they're going to go forward with that in a general way to say, if you want to do that, this is how you do it. I don't know whether they're going to tag that to a specific place or not. I think it's pretty clear at this point that we don't need to tag it to a specific
place. So is that in here yet, or is that...
No,
that's not in here at all.
No, that it's still to come. It's Article 27.
Oh, well, okay.
And it should be.
Oh, yeah.
And...
Mine just says, amend the general bylaws by adding...
Well, that's just generally just put placeholder.
Just the placeholder here.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's what that's about. And I have updated this. I've updated the list of people being elected to reflect the election warrant, which is coming right up on the agenda. So all in all, the budget is progressing nicely. I just need figures from the schools. Then I'll have to match up everything that's being proposed to the expected revenues and make sure that I present a balanced budget. And then whatever happens, I encourage you to think carefully. Of course, cutting things is never a problem in terms of if I present a balanced budget, you can always cut things. But last minute additions to any budget have to be made very carefully just in case we find ourselves close to the levy limit, and we don't want to pass a budget that exceeds the levy limit. So,
I only recommend this to be added to the bottom, but that's just, I mean, we need to discuss it with the Finance Committee and the full board. But if we could have a non-binding vote question on this, I don't know if you can legally do that or not. But I've been talking, a lot of the town citizens have been talking to me about wondering why we haven't decided to move the town garage forward in a more expediting manner.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess I would, as one of the selectmen, I would recommend that maybe we, if we could put together some sort of question, non-binding question, for a vote on town meeting floor, as to whether the town should move forward with that again.
Well, there is a proposed $100,000 to add to the stabilization mm-hmm. fund, which would, for the first time since it was proposed, bring us up to the level that we had before when we tried it, when people thought it cost too much money. Mm-hmm. So, in a way, I would think that that question would help, that that article would help answer mm-hmm. that question if people do vote for that, especially if we asked for a, and it's going into a stabilization fund, so it will be a two-thirds vote. So certainly if we get a two-thirds vote on that article, that would indicate that two-thirds of the people support a town garage.
Well, they
now,
do,
two-thirds of the people supported a town garage last time by voting mm-hmm. for the $100,000 to go in and then spending it you know, on the design and engineering, and ended up not voting for the garage itself because the cost, which was an absolute minimum cost, it will only cost more than it did last time. And I'm happy to present any of this information during the discussion, during the debate on the article.
I didn't know if we could do an informal question on that.
Well, is the sense you get that people
sense I
are
get
more people, positive
they
about
come to
it?
Me, say they want to know why we aren't starting to think about moving forward.
Constantly thinking
yes.
about it.
So,
but
once you get your hands burned, you know it's.
Well, I mean,
no, I mean,
I understand that.
Yes,
it's been what 3 years?
It
four
would
years?
Be a great, and we still have not replenished the coffers. And if the town voted not to fund it because it cost too much money on the tax base, mm-hmm. with a plan that was well constructed, fairly complex, in order to get it to cost the absolute least it possibly could, we were actually borrowing less than $2 million. Mm-hmm. If we went forward, say, this year with it, we would not be able to offer borrowing for less than $2 million. Mm-hmm. It would be very helpful to be able to offer a plan that costs less than the one we did last time, which means putting more money into stabilization.
What are we getting in now? $900,000, something like that?
No. No, again, we had slightly less than $800,000 last time.
Oh, okay.
And we don't have that amount in there now. We need, I'm not sure exactly how much we need, but it is under that amount. $100,000 would bring us over that amount, and we would start to make up where we were. But if we wanted to bring it down substantially from borrowing $2 million to, say, $1.5 million, that would mean putting in another $500,000.
Right.
So this $100,000 is kind of
years.
A down payment on that.
Yeah.
So it is in some.
But by the time another 5 years roll around, the bill is not going to be $3 million.
It's
going to
cost more.
It's going to be $5 million.
That's right.
So, at what point do you say enough's enough?
This was one of the strongest reasons mm-hmm. for voting it at the time. It was insufficient because people didn't want to borrow $2 million as a mm-hmm. town. Now, I think. One of the reasons it didn't go through was from some people who seemed to not want to vote for any kind of town project
right.
until broadband went through.
Right.
Once broadband goes through, I think we're playing in a different arena.
Yeah.
And so,
there's multiple reasons.
So over the next year, as things get wired, I think it might make it possible to go forward in the following year's town meeting. Again, it's going to be, the project we have is the cheapest way to do it. We made sure of that. And if people didn't like that project, then they'll only get something that costs more.
What was the total on that, you remember?
Well, there were various figures.
Yeah.
There's,
I'd have to look back.
The borrowing was going to be, you know, almost $2 million. Mm-hmm. I don't think we'd have to pay as much for design and engineering, because we could, in one way or another, start from the design we have. Mm-hmm. That said, it's going to take, unless it were the same firm who won the bid, it would take
that firm a lot less money.
A certain amount of money to recreate that, and a firm isn't going to bid on a project that's not. It's going to be a small project. It was already a small project last time. That was one of the reasons we had so few bidders on it last time. Mm. So we're making it into even smaller a project if we say we want to save money by doing it this way. But if the previous designer wanted to come in and bid for it, that would be the best case scenario. Yeah. And we could save substantial money that way.
Well, by town meeting a year from now, the second group of homes, so virtually every home in Conway should be connected with broadband.
Mm-hmm.
That by this year, the construction will be going on, but none of the extension will have been finished. Mm-hmm. But over the course of that year, half of them will be connected, and right around the time that town meeting will happen is when the second group should mm-hmm. be connected.
And I do think there are other reasons it didn't pass that also don't hold now. So I do think I am more optimistic about it going forward at roughly the same level it did before, if we can manage that.
Well, my question here was this.
So,
because whenever you're going to do it, whatever year you're going to propose to do it, it's going to take about a year to put the package back together again to get the taxpayers' vote. Correct? Takes almost a year.
So you're to some extent saying, could we have a straw poll at town meeting?
Depends.
Mm-hmm. I think that would be great if we had a straw poll at town meeting that would say, what do you think? Mm-hmm. Come to town meeting a year from now with a proposal.
Or not. Or wait another year.
Or wait longer. Yeah.
Or wait longer.
Yeah. Well, I'll be happy to draft something like that. It would be good to get an indication.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Again, because I think some things have shifted.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, well, it can't be binding at this point. We have a lot of work to do
to put
together a proposal, a serious proposal for that.
That's a great idea.
Okay.
People may say they're for it, but they said they were for it last time. And mm-hmm. then at the last minute, they weren't, so.
The unfortunate thing is, Conway has never, ever spent hardly any money on infrastructure projects other than their grammar school.
Mm-hmm.
In Conway.
And it shows.
It shows.
It is not a proper level of investment in the community. So then the question is, where do you think it should be placed in the warrant? You want it before the capital items?
We can discuss
first
that.
Thing?
We can discuss that.
Yeah, think about it.
I think as town meetings tend to go on, time-wise,
earlier
further into town meeting you go, people start fading out of the building.
So earlier is better.
Earlier would be better.
Well, we could have it. How about having it right after the vote for the...
For the
garage stabilization.
Yeah.
I mean, that would...
Yeah.
It makes sense, and...
At least it'd give us a guide point as to what direction we should do.
It's a great idea.
Tons of people like to see us head.
Yeah. Again, just a caution. Just because people vote for something...
Well, I understand that.
...that isn't binding.
I mean, you could put another plan together, and then they come back another year, and they vote it down again. I mean...
Yeah.
It is possible, but if you don't put anything forward, nothing will happen.
Nothing will happen, right. So, okay, is that all you got for that warrant, Tom?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see. The next agenda is new business. Signed DEP contract for Sustainable Materials Recovery Program and Related Work. Is that in here?
Now, what I would advise you to do, because we also have to sign a contract authorization signatory form, which is a form that somebody signs it, and then they're the official signer of the various contracts. In the past, John has done that. If you just voted to approve this, maybe I could get John to come in and he could do the actual signing.
Okay. Do we have the agreement here somewhere?
Yeah, should be in there. We can have more than, we can have everybody as signatories on it if we want. So you could do that too.
I just think we just need one. I wouldn't think we need all of us, do you? Most contracts you have just one person. Mm-hmm.
Okay, great.
You gotta copy this.
Oh, that's the cover letter.
That's a cover letter, right?
Yeah. That's just FYI.
Mm-hmm. Yep. So do we want to take a vote?
Sure.
Okay, I'll make a motion that we
probably
have the chairman of the select board with his approval, of course, sign the contract for sustainable materials recovery program and related work. Do you have a second for that?
Second.
All those in favor?
Sure.
All right.
Thank you.
John can sign that.
So John will sign that.
Okay, next thing, signed a warrant for an annual town caucus to be held on March 6th, 2017. And we have a citizen caucus March 6th at 8 p.m. in the town hall. John O'Rourke for selectmen's running.
Those are actually just the positions that are open.
Right, the positions that are open. Would be one select board member, one assessor, two members of Board of Health, two members of local school committee, two planning board members, and a tree warden and a moderator. So I'll make a motion to approve or sign this for make it official.
Yeah.
Second it?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
So done. We'll both sign it then. This one, yeah, this one.
And the names there are the people who are dropping off, or who are...
Well,
whose position
who's
is
your,
up. That's the way to put it.
Right, that's the way to put it.
Save that for...
Okay, next item is a discussion requiring a time frame for appointees to be sworn in.
Yes, this request is coming both from the town clerk and my office. We've had some trouble sometimes getting people to get sworn into the positions to which they've been appointed, mm-hmm. Which in the eyes of the law means that they're not yet actually legally a member of that committee or board or whatever mm-hmm. it is. And in the normal course of events, it doesn't really matter all that much because most committees are doing things that don't involve sums of money or great responsibility. However, occasionally, even in that situation, we find sometimes that people want to find out that things are being done properly. Now, it didn't happen during the current housing debate, but it very well could have. And to avoid, to make sure that it doesn't become an issue,
okay.
It would be handy if we could, when we write a letter saying you've been appointed, say something like, this appointment is good for, say, a month. Give them, you know, a month or... we could make it longer than that, but I really wouldn't want to because we want them to start going to meetings and participating right away. It's very important for things like the planning board, mm-hmm. obviously, where you're making decisions that that turn into bylaws and things like that. That if somebody went back and looked at the record, they could find some technicality. This is, you know, one of those technicalities you hear about cases being thrown out over. It would be great if this weren't something that somebody could challenge. Okay. So,
would it be better to say something like that they can't vote?
Well, it's true.
As a member of the
board,
they can't. I mean, rather, you know, and maybe so, that would encourage people to.
I don't think they necessarily would pay attention to that. But if the appointment were only good for a month, unless they got sworn in, you know, this is you'd appoint them for a year contingent on their being sworn in within a month, something like that. And, you know, if we knew of somebody's personal circumstance where they were going to be away for a period of time, but the committee still wanted them to be appointed, say over the summer or something like that, we could make exceptions.
Exceptions, right.
But the rule would be that you really have to get sworn in pretty quickly in order to participate.
Okay.
We have included stronger language since I've been here. Our language has gotten stronger in the committee appointment letters about being sworn in. But there's still some foot dragging going on. And it does cause us problems, especially in communication with the town clerk about who's on a committee and who isn't. So it helps us very much to know who is actually on a committee, which means they have to be sworn in. So that's, I just put that out now as a discussion point.
You know what other towns do?
Think about it. I don't.
Don't do it.
And I will ask. I bet they don't have. Well, I bet they have the same problem, and I bet they ignore it, and I bet it causes them problems every once in a while.
I have heard from some people that have been appointed or recommended to be appointed to committees in the town of Conway that say that there is no convenient time for them to come in to get sworn in because they work Monday through Friday out of town from 7 o'clock in the morning to 5 o'clock at night. So that they would ask, they asked, and they said if there was any way possible that the office where it does the appointments could either have an evening where they could come in and sign, or a Saturday morning or something like that. Because they're just totally unavailable, some of these people, during the weekdays. And I understand that.
Yeah.
Ginny is absolutely open to making appointments outside of her regular hours. She has sworn people in on the street. She's sworn people in at the library when she worked there. She'll swear people in when she's over in the Board of Health, just so long as if people make an appointment with her. So yes, she is available outside of those hours, but people do have to contact her and make an appointment for that.
So that should be put in the letter. Also,
yes, she is available by appointment.
They have by making a phone appointment with her. Correct?
Well, an appointment.
Right.
You know, that should do it.
Because in the past, a whole bunch of years in the town of Conway, there's been a few people that have always said that unfortunate thing with the town clerk's office position is there's no evening available for them to come through to get their work done, or no one Saturday month or something like that in the morning or whatever the charge. But it was strictly only 3 days a week, and it's inaccessible to all these people at that time.
And
I'm not talking to get appointed. I'm talking about just general business.
Yeah, and Ginny did hold evening hours for quite some time, and no one came in. And
I
so
got.
I think
she should relook at that. That's just my own personal feelings.
Well, then you should probably let her know as elected official to elected official.
Oh.
And you have to have taken the state course, right, the ethics course, before you can be sworn in. I mean, I think you come into Ginny with your
I don't know if they do or not. No, I don't think so.
It doesn't have to be done in that order. It does have to be done in order to be a full member.
Right.
And we do include that information as well.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So would we want to discuss this further with John, or would you like to vote on that? No, make a time frame and vote.
No, I hadn't intended to ask for a vote at this time. I'm just
sometimes the board lacks carrying on discussion from week to week, yeah. And we drop these items.
Oh, I'm happy to put it on next time for John.
Okay.
And brief him on the discussion okay. as well.
Let's do that.
But if you could call a couple
and
of them.
I'll ask Stan, too, to see if they have
what
a
policy.
Yeah.
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 And ask about the assessor of town clerk availability in these towns when you're talking to them. Whether they have an evening or Saturday hours, just for my information. While you're talking to them, okay? Seeing you're gonna have them on the phone, so.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll move on to the next item then. Signed a 5-year work anniversary letter for Conan Pelk. And Conan is a 5-year member of the fire department. And it doesn't say here what else, but I think it's just fire department. He's been employed by the town of Conway. And the ambulance, evidently. So, because Jim has signed it. I would Great. Make a motion, second motion to sign a letter of congratulations.
I'd second it.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Good. I'll sign it.
Wonderful.
Let's see, we signed above the line?
I think so, yeah. And you'll have to have John sign this.
Yeah. Okay, next item is items not anticipated 48 hours in advance.
I don't have anything.
Anything? Okay. Town administrator update.
Just a few things. The superintendent and business manager of Smith Technical and Vocational High School will be visiting at the next meeting, February 13th, to introduce themselves. This was the date that they could make it,
nice.
And I don't think there's anything particularly pressing on the agenda mm-hmm. for next week, so they did ask to come in on that date, so I told them I'd pencil it in. Now I can, if you agree to that, I'll
that sounds fine to me.
Confirm with them. Okay. The Finance Committee has proposed the next joint meeting be February 21st or 27th. I'll be releasing my draft budget February 21st, so that could be a good day.
So these are when we meet with them over in Town Hall?
Yeah, at least for informational purposes, which I have proposed to them, or they might want to take some time to digest it. Jim was actually leaning towards the 27th.
I would think that'd be better.
And this would be for...
give them time to, and us time to digest it.
Yeah, and... proposals for mm-hmm. for both cutting things and for the sources of funds that would be used for the various things. One of the things that I'll be proposing is to take the capital stabilization funds to raise and appropriate for that. And that'll be the first time this year, instead of taking it from free cash. I think it's one of the most important items on the budget, and therefore one of the most compelling to get people to actually vote to raise and appropriate. As you know, we have not as much free cash
right.
as we
right.
used to have. We have a little more than we did right. last year. But we have more in stabilization money required than we have free cash to cover it all. So that being the most compelling item, I thought that might be raised and appropriate. So that's why I'm going to mm-hmm. be proposing that
yeah.
source for that item. So that's the kind of thing, the sources of money for the items, what to cut,
mm-hmm.
that sort of thing. It might also be good to have the ambulance. We'll have to cover the ambulance money at some point. So we'll have to get an accounting from Joyce on
right.
that. The Wastewater Committee has proposed a town meeting warrant item for $100,000 for engineering for a wastewater engineering study. As I mentioned before, I don't think I have to go through this. It came in late for the deadline for capital articles. The timeline was that he didn't get bids, and that they've had to go back and work with the likely bidder. And I've asked Joe if he would present it to the Capital Improvement Planning Committee. He has agreed, after I wrote this, and I have let them know.
Well,
and so they are meeting next on February 22nd.
Capital Improvement.
That's also tentatively scheduled for February 22nd.
Does Joe intend on coming in and discuss this with the board too?
I would, if it gets through Capital Improvement, the Capital Improvement Planning Committee, I would expect him to come to the board, yes. I have gotten, for departmental news, I've gotten a suggestion to provide more information on the website. I am planning a website upgrade with Roy using existing funds. This was something town meeting wanted quite a while ago that hasn't been implemented yet. But I've gotten through the first bit of IT renovation here, and now we can focus on the website. It addresses some of the intent of the suggestion, my upgrade proposal, by providing notifications of changes to particular pages to anyone who subscribes to that page, known as an RSS feed, or something similar to the opt-in email list suggested to me. At this point, posting all meeting notices and minutes for all committees and boards seems to me to be beyond the resources we have available. That was the full request. But we can certainly make a start having, you know, more things available and letting people know when things are posted.
Okay. Sounds good to me.
And Lisa and Roy and I will be talking about that. We'll also be sending out a request for ideas for an enhanced website. So if anyone has any functionality they want, please let us know. We should be sending that out pretty soon.
You ready? Any questions from Tom? Bob? Oh, okay. All right. Next item is concerns of the selectmen.
No.
I have one concern. I understand from street talk that we no longer have a highway employee. The new guy's already resigned.
The new guy?
That was this morning.
So I would recommend to Tom and the highway superintendent that they probably going to have to advertise again, I guess. And I would suggest we get on it right away because we've still got 2.5 months of the winter. And the way we've been striking out.
The current plan of the highway superintendent, which I have endorsed, is to use temporary labor for the moment because the hiring process takes quite some time. Mm-hmm. We might need somebody soon, and he's looking into contractors to help out temporarily.
I think we need to get the process going right away. What do you think, Bob?
I do, yeah, sure.
So can you handle that? Well, I guess you got to advertise, right?
Again? Oh, absolutely.
So
absolutely.
Because you pretty much ran out of exhausted candidates before, right?
Yes. I don't think we want to go back to the pools that we've developed several months ago.
So if you could get that out as soon as possible and get the ball rolling again?
I'll check with the highway superintendent and see how if he has any further thoughts on that. And if he has any concerns about that, I'll get back to the board.
Well, I mean,
our recommendation is to let's get moving on right away.
I'll certainly do that.
So we don't want to waste any time. We want to get him the help he needs.
Right. The help he needs might be tomorrow. So
I understand
he's
that.
He's not going to wait to try to find somebody to plow.
Yeah. So the sooner you can get moving, the better. I think Bob, you agree.
Is there a problem that we should know about?
He's already moved. He's already moving on it.
Great.
So. No, we have no reason.
Seemed like a nice fella.
Seemed like it.
Yeah.
He worked well one day. I guess.
Not very long.
Not very long.
And then he wasn't present for several days. Submitted his resignation this morning by text.
Nice. Hard to hire people.
All right. Next item is, you got any concerns?
No.
Okay. Next item is mail. We have a couple items here. We have attention to selectmen. This is a soil in your community challenge to,
So Bryce is working on this. I do know that.
Oh, what? You know, right? What are you talking about?
Well, Bryce knows about this, and it's basically a competition that assuming at some point we do go through with building solar, perhaps, you know, behind the grammar school, this is a competition we could apply for that would, if we win the competition, it would give us a prize. It wouldn't be money that we could use ahead of time to help fund the thing, or it would be something that after you've built the thing and show that it's working and can promote that it's got qualities like, certain innovative aspects to it that are reproducible in other towns like ours, then you would win a prize.
Okay.
That'd be a windfall, you know.
Okay,
but
good. Can this be done prior to your building your solar or not?
Yes, you would have to do it prior, yeah.
Right.
So Bryce is already looking at what it would take to apply.
Okay, good.
That's great.
Okay. All right, the other piece of mail is a letter from the Mass Municipal Association.
Did you want this?
The
you can leave it in
2017 the Spring Legislative Breakfast Meeting. To be held February 24th in Ipswich in Bedford, March 3rd in Greenfield at the Community College, and in Leominster, and on March 10th in Brookline and Lenox. I think I'm going to try to make this one.
I signed up for it.
You already have?
Okay. Yeah.
You should have an email.
It's fairly painless. And
well, then you can take that.
When did the emails come off, John?
I'm sorry?
When did the emails come out on it?
I got one.
The date should be on it. Is it not dated?
No. That's what I got to say. I got it on the back page.
Oh, they didn't date the letter?
January 27th. Huh.
Yeah, it's pretty much just came out.
Yeah. Let's look back. Jim, I don't remember seeing this, but I will look.
Well, feel free to take that one if you want.
I will.
Sure, but I think you can apply online.
Yeah, I will. That's probably as close as you're going to get coming economy.
Yeah, that's right. It's only up at GCC.
Yeah, well, GCC.
Well, they were here just a couple of years ago.
They were. We had a breakfast right here in Conway.
Yeah, they did.
Bob,
I remember
gave
that.
Us coffee, for which we all were very grateful.
How was that there? Because you invited all the department heads, too.
Yeah.
And that was a good meeting.
Mm-hmm.
Great. Okay. Any announcements? Hearing no announcements. Our next meeting is scheduled for Monday, February 13th, at 6 p.m. here in the town office.
Great.
If I hear no other business, I make a motion that we close the meeting.
Second.
Second it? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.